Hello, my friends, and welcome back to another episode of MTD CNC North America. And today I have the pleasure of being with my friends at Vollmer America. Now, I'm with Derek, and we're standing in front of a V-Grind 360. I am so excited to learn a bit more about how this machine works and how it could benefit all of our viewers today. So, Derek, thank you so much for being a part of MTD.
Oh, thank you for having me.
So let's talk. Let's get right into it, my friend. Let's talk about this V-Grind 360, and let's start from the beginning. What does it do?
So this machine was introduced in 2014, its predecessor, the V-Grind 160, and what it does is it produces rotary tooling, carbide, high-speed steel, for all those out there who are using milling machines. So we make a wide range of tooling from end mills, drill bits, special form cutters, a lot of woodworking tools, so things like slitter blades or compression routers, burrs, you name it. If it's rotary, we can grind it.
Wow. Okay. So starting from there, you mentioned rotary and we can grind it. And I know there's some real significance to this machine and some of the other machines that are out there. Some of that has to do with the software. Some of that has to do with the precision and rigidity of the machine itself, right? So let's talk a little bit about what sets this machine apart from some of the other animals that are out there.
Well, first of all, it's German. So it's better, it's the rigidity of it. So Vollmer's been in business for so long, they have 109 plus years experience. So they incorporated a lot of their knowledge from the older machines, the saw blade machines and things like that, and they incorporated it into this grinding machine. So it comes with a lot of experience. It has the rigidity, the base for vibration dampening. The way that it's designed is unlike most of the grinders you're going to see out there. So a lot of our competitors have a single spindle design. So it's hanging from one point. Whereas this machine, they designed the grinding wheels to be more rigid. So they designed it so that it has a top mounting and a bottom mounting surface. So that keeps the rigidity, also absorbs more of the vibrations and things like that.
That makes sense to me. So let's pretend for a moment that I've never run one of these machines and I'm trying to understand where I might be able to utilize this best in my facility, as we see a lot of companies trying to do a lot more in-house. We're trying to be self-sustained, right? So I'm viewing this right now. I'm part of the audience right now. I'm looking at this. I know it's German made. I'm listening to Derek talk. I know this thing's rigid and it's unique and it's been around for over 100 years, 110 plus years, right? So if I'm just now getting introduced, tell me about this machine and how it can help benefit me at my facility.
Well, it's definitely one of the biggest costs is setup time. So you have multiple things involved in your setup. You have scrap rate, so how many tools are you going to scrap to get yourself to a good intolerance tool? The other thing is the time that it takes you to get there. So you might have five scrap pieces and you might set up a lot faster, but that's wasted money. So what this machine is doing is when we set this up at your facility, it's within 5 microns per axis. So when what you see on the screen is what you get on the tool. So we've had multiple customers that are just surprised that when we put this in your plant and we say, it's yours, it's good to go, those tools are coming out exactly what they expect them to be.
So obviously we're talking about precision here, right?
Yes.
But how easy is it to get to that point? The software itself is significant on its own. The customers like it. How easy is it to learn and how easy is it to adapt to a person being new to it?
Yeah, the software, I like to say if you can do something on our competitor's machine, you can do it on this machine. Obviously, there's a learning curve there. And we at Vollmer, we understand that learning curve. One of the things that I really pushed for when I started on board here was the 2 weeks of training as opposed to a traditional 1 week of training that you get with some competitors. So we automatically give you 2 weeks of training up front because we know that you're gonna have some problems with the software, you're gonna have some learning curves, and you can't cram everything into 1 week. So we want to be there for the customers, we want to support them. So it's not just the machine and what it can do, it's also the service and what we can provide. So, we give them the 1 week training, get them fresh with the machine, the control panel, how to operate the wheel changer, and then, come back and we hit the more intensive, harder subjects that they might have questions on.
That also makes sense. And I say it makes sense a lot, but I appreciate you conveying that information to myself and the audience. Let's talk a little bit about the software since we're looking at it here.
Yep.
What makes this software unique and somewhat user-friendly?
So one of the nice things about Numeroto is that it is on other competitors' machines. So some of our competitors have proprietary software. It kind of pigeonholes you in certain aspects. So when you get comfortable with that software, you tend to go back to that company because you're comfortable with it. With Numeroto, they're on multiple machines. I believe it's 12 or more machines. So it's nice for customers when we go in there and they already have experience with a competitor's machine with Numeroto, there is no learning curve. It's a one for one. They jump on the machine, they have to learn the buttons. It maybe takes a day or two to learn how it operates, but they're off to the races. So the software is so versatile and it's on multiple machines, it makes it easier to, and that's one of the reasons why Vollmer went with Numeroto, was because it was proven in the market. It's been out there for many years since, I believe it was the 2000s, early 2000s. So people are familiar with it, they like it. And like I said, it's easy to learn if you know how to do it on another machine. It's a quick, just learning where the buttons are, pretty much.
Yeah. That, again, having that familiarity is so important, right? When we think about some of the machines on the market today around the world and any part of our industry, even a really incredible high caliber machine, if it has a software that people don't understand, sometimes they get lost in it, right? And it ends up getting left behind in a shop where it could be the most superior machine in the shop. However, people are afraid to use it. So being able to have that universal software that people understand, now it's just adapting to Vollmer themselves, correct?
Correct, yeah. And the nice thing about Numeroto is they work really well with all their OEMs. And you can see from the 3D simulation here, almost every aspect of the machine can be simulated, minus the coolant lines, because those could really be anywhere. But any aspect of the machine can be simulated. And the nice thing about it is the 3D collision detection is pretty spot on. I mean, it you can be within a couple millimeters and you're safe to put that tool in and grind it. As long as you don't have a collision on the screen, you're good to grind that tool and you're not going to have any kind of collisions.
I like that as well. So we know that this machine is precise. We know that it's rigid. We know it's German made. We know you've been around since 1909. We know the software is universal so people understand it. But let's talk a little bit about the automation aspect of it, right? Because people are trying to run lights out machining.
Yeah.
Is this also adaptable to automation?
Yes, it is. It has a lot of different, we have four different loaders for this machine, depending on your needs. Some people like the Fanuc system. They have it on their other machines. They work with that. So they buy the Fanuc system, which is a four pallet production system. Then we have a compact system. It also holds four pallets. It's a little bit less tooling, but it's a little bit easier. If you're not familiar with the Fanuc, it can be a little scary. You don't want to mess around with the pennant or anything. Then your safer bet is to go with that. The HC loader goes up to a much larger size diameter, heavier tooling. So if you're doing some large diameter, 2-inch diameter tools, you're better to go with the HC4 like we have on this machine. It's got some, you know, there's plus and minuses to all of them, but many different options for whatever the customer might need.
I like that you brought up options, and I like that you brought up sometimes fear, because in your facility that we're standing in right now, you guys also help with turnkey operations, and you mentioned 2 weeks of support. But I imagine there's more support that comes with it when there's questions as well. So not only are you supporting them via Zoom, via phone calls, via on-site service, but you have turnkey here as well, which allows them to feel comfortable and confident in getting into the Vollmer swimming pool, right?
Yeah. So like you said, we offer a lot of different support for our customers. As you said, with COVID-19, we started our virtual training. So we can do training online via Zoom or Teams, whatever they have. But also the support, as you mentioned, is being on top of the support. So being quick to reply to the customer is huge. I don't know if you know this, but before I came to Vollmer, I was a tool grinder myself. So I was a tool grinder for 10 years. So I dealt with the competitors, the service aspect, the response times and things like that. And so being in this position now, I can really make a difference, you know, because I can get back to my customers, you know, that day within an hour, let's say, and get the problems fixed a lot quicker. So that's one of the things that I enjoy about this job. So.
Well, Derek, I didn't know that. I'm happy to know that. And I bet our viewers are happy to know that as well, knowing that he didn't just jump in and say, I know it all. No, you went through it and learned and were a grinder yourself. So going into the field that you are now, I imagine that type of education is really beneficial to anyone who calls you.
Yep, for sure. Yeah, because it's one of those things that being an application engineer, it's every day it's something different. You know, you get different tools in, you get different problems. But when you're out there actually grinding the tools, you actually see a lot more things, more problems. Maybe you don't have the right wheel, maybe you don't have the right setup, so you got to make things work for what, however you can. So, you know, it's those aspects that can help the customer. Hey, well, have you thought of trying this wheel instead of that wheel, you know, because those are things you learn with experience, you know, and doing it as an application engineer, sometimes you don't get that experience unless you're knee deep in it. So.
Well, you've certainly struck my interest, which means I guarantee you some of these viewers right now are curious to hear, learn more as well, right? So if someone is interested in Vollmer, where can they find you to do some more research? Website, socials, any of that kind of stuff?
Yeah, so the website's www.vollmer-group.com. Quite a bit of videos on YouTube. Best thing is to contact your sales rep, your local sales rep, because they're directly in contact with the application engineers. So if there's any questions or concerns, and they're very good at that as well. So if there's something that they're not sure, they won't answer the customer necessarily right away. They'll get back to them and you know, I'll get a phone call or something to get some further information. But the local sales reps are the best way to get more information on the machine. But our website also, and YouTube, things like that.
Beautiful. Well, Derek, I appreciate you sharing this information, conveying this information with our global audience. You're a good man, and I wish you all the success moving forward.
You too.